Hi, good day all of you. Welcome to our session. Welcome to our channel, Intelligible Tutorials. In this today's session now, we are going to describe about the path predicate expressions. In the previous videos, already we have completed the predicate interpretation, how a predicate can be represented, what are the things relevant to the predicate. All these things we have seen in our previous videos. Now we are going to see the path predicate expressions. What is the path predicate actually? Actually, a path predicate is regarded as the collection of the Boolean expressions, and all of them must be satisfied and they can be directed to achieve the particular path, which is obviously the selected path. That is called the path predicate expressions. Okay, so path predicate expression is a collection of the set of Boolean expressions, and all the Boolean expressions can be satisfied to go along with the selected path. So what are the various examples of the path predicates now we are going to see. Let us see. The first example of the path predicate is x1 plus x2, 3x2 plus 17. This is the very first example. And greater than or equal to 0. x1 plus 3x2 plus 17 greater than or equal to 0. And the second one is x3 is equal to 17 and x4 minus x1 greater than or equal to 14x2. So here all these are the set of Boolean expressions. Okay, they can give either result true or result false. Okay, so these are the collection of the set various kinds of the Boolean expressions. Now, another kind of the examples of path predicate here now we are going to see. Let us see here. A, B, C, D, E. Here, 5 number of the examples are given in this example. The first one is x5 greater than 0. It may be either true or false, that is directly Boolean. And x6 less than 0. So it is also one kind of the Boolean expression, E. And coming to the B, x1 plus 3x2 plus 17 greater than or equal to 0. And C is x3 equal to 0. And D is x4 minus x1 greater than or equal to 14x2. So comparing to the previous example, we have added some new things. Those are nothing but E and as well as the C. Okay. So this example, these are the collection of the examples that gives the information related to the Boolean expressions in the form of the path predicate expressions. Okay, so Boolean algebra notation to denote the Boolean expression. Now this can be represented as ABCD plus EBCD is equal to A plus E into BCD. So this is the Boolean algebraic expression where we can substitute all the X values, A value, B value, C value and D value in it in order to get the Boolean expression, to get the achievable path. So this is the path predicate example. This is treated as the path predicate expression. And this is one of the best example of the path predicate expression. Okay. So now we are going to talk about the predicate coverage. What is the meaning of the predicate coverage? What are the contents of it? Now we are going to see. So in this regard, we are going to talk about the very first one, compound predicate. What is the meaning of the compound predicate? Okay, so the compound predicate that can contain some kind of the logical expressions or Boolean expressions in it. Okay, we can combine two or more logical expressions, then we can say that is a compound predicate. For example, predicates of the form that is given as A or B and A and B. So these two are the very good examples of the compound predicates. And complicated Boolean expressions also, these can be often regarded as. And finally, we can say these as the compound predicates. See, in the previous slide, what is the meaning of the A here? In the previous slide, the A is x5 greater than 0. And what is the B? x1 plus 3x2 plus 7 greater than or equal to 0. Like that, these two predicates can be combined with the help of A or B and A and B. Like R is one kind of the logical operator, and as well as AND is also one kind of the logical operator. So if we combine two or multiple number of the Boolean expressions with the help of logical expressions, then obviously it can be called as a compound predicate. So this is the meaning of the compound predicate. Okay, and coming to the second point, sometimes even a simple predicate we have designed is also becomes as a compound after its interpretation. How it is in this example we see now. The given predicate is given as x is equal to 7 and whose opposite branch is x not equal to 7. So we have combined both with R operator. So finally it can be regarded as x greater than 7 or x less than 7. This x greater than 7, for example, we have considered as P, or and we denoted is this x less than 7, 17 is denoted as Q. Simply we can represent this as P or Q. Okay, so what is P here? X greater than 17. And what is QE here? X less than 17. So this is also one example of the compound predicate. Like that, the things what I have underlined or rounded here, A or B, and A and B, and P or Q, these are the very good examples of what of compound predicates. Okay, next. Predicate coverage. Now we are going to talk about the predicate coverage. What is the meaning of the predicate coverage actually? So the predicate coverage is normally we can achieve by all the possible truth values in the selected path. So in the given path, we have obtained all the true values for all the logical expressions or for all the Boolean expressions. Then we can say that is called as the predicate coverage. So predicate coverage throughout line, it contains only the true values only. So we can often regarded as predicate coverage is nothing but true values always. Okay, so it is true values. Okay, so it is achieving the desired direction. So whatever direction already you have predicted, that direction only it will go at the given decision, and sometimes it may hide the bugs also in the associated predicates. So what is the predicate coverage? Achieving all the true values in the intended destination, that is called as the predicate coverage. And in this regard, it can also have some bugs are also in it. Here in this regard, we need to talk about, to discuss about the bugs in the predicate coverage. Okay, normally what kind of the bugs, what type of the chances of the bugs that we can have here, we are going to see now. Here first we are going to talk about the testing blindness. What is the meaning of the testing blindness actually? The testing blindness is often regarded as the very vulnerable situation or pathological or harmful situation in which whatever path we have desired is not given, but the path we have achieved for the wrong reason. Okay, without any correct reason we are going to the right path. So that is called as the testing blindness. So whatever path you are intended, you are going along with the same path, but without any reason. That is called as the testing blindness. So it is often regarded as the pathological situation or harmful situation or unwanted situation. So here, this kind of the testing blindness is designed into three different types. So what is the first one here? Now we are going to see. 1 minute. So here it is assignment blindness, equality blindness, and self blindness. These are the three different kinds of the testing blindness. First of all, we see what is the meaning of the assignment blindness. See here, the assignment blindness occurs. It is one kind of the blindness where the buggy predicate appears to work correctly because the specific value chosen for an assignment statement works with both correct and incorrect predicate. That means whatever value you have assigned, okay, so the buggy predicate appears to work correctly, okay, with the assignment statement that will work for both correct predicate and as well as the incorrect predicate. Because of the assignment value you have assigned to a particular variable, Okay, so the variable is acting correctly for the buggy predicate and as well as the correct predicate both. Okay, so how it is with the help of one example now we are going to see. Let us see in this example the two situations are clearly given here. What are they now we are going to see. The first one is the correct situation and the second one is the buggy situation. First of all, we see the correct situation. X is assigned a value as 7. If y greater than or equal to 0, then. Okay. So, okay. Then what we have to do, it is clearly given in the next forthcoming sentences. Now, coming to the buggy. X is equal to 7. Here also the value assigned as 7 in the x. But if x plus y greater than 0, here you have given x value as 7 plus y greater than 0, then. This situation is the buggy situation. Okay. So here you should not include this x in this particular Boolean expression. Okay. So the particular value, whatever you have assigned 7 here, it will works correctly for both this kind of the situation and as well as the this kind of the situation. Okay. So this feature is called as the blindness. Okay. So what is the name of this situation is often regarded as assignment blindness. Whatever value you have assigned here, the particular value that will work for correct predicate and as well as the incorrect predicate. That's what is called as the assignment blindness. Okay, it is also one kind of the testing blindness. The next one is called as the equality blindness. What is the meaning of the equality blindness? Okay, so it occurs when the path selected by a prior predicate results in a value that works both for correct and as well as the buggy predicate. So whatever path you have selected by a previous predicate in a value we have selected that works both for correct predicate and as well as the buggy predicate. How it is now we are going to see. For example, here also two kind of the situations, the correct situation or the correct predicate and as well as the buggy predicate. First of all, we see the correct predicate in the correct version. If y is equal to 2, then x plus y greater than 3, then. Here you have included this y also in this expression. Okay, it's well and good, it works. Okay, so now coming to the if y is equal to 2, then. If x greater than 1, then. Here, you don't know the value of the x. You have to include the y also here. Okay. But here, y is not there. But it works well for a buggy situation also if y is equal to 2. Okay. So, this is called the equality blindness. Okay. So, equality blindness means what? Previously, we have seen. It is occurs when the path selected for a prior predicate. Whatever path you have selected for a prior predicate in a value that works both correct and as well as the buggy predicate. The path you have selected for a value at y is equal to 2. Okay, so it works well for the correct predicate x plus y greater than 3 and x greater than 1 also as the buggy predicate. For that also it will works well. Okay, so this is called the equality blindness. The next one is the self blindness. What is the meaning of the self blindness? Okay, so self-blindness occurs normally in the buggy predicate is multiple of the correct predicate and as a result is indistinguishable along the path. Okay, so how it is differentiating? The assignment x is equal to makes a predicate multiple of each other. So the direction taken is the same for the correct and buggy version. So whatever value you have taken, whatever assignment you have taken, okay, the predicate multiples of each other so that the direction is same for correct version and as well as the buggy version. For example, again two situations, correct situation and as well as the buggy situation. Coming to the correct situation for the self-blindness, x is equal to a is given and x is equal to a here also given. If x minus 1 greater than 0, then here you have given in the buggy if x plus a minus 2 greater than 0, then. Okay, so this is the buggy situation. So here it won't works well. Whereas this one is the correct situation. Okay, so self-bindedness occurs when the buggy predicate is multiple of the correct predicate. Okay, then as a result, it is indistinguishable along the path. So it is multiplied or added or subtracted from the existing variable, whatever it is called as the buggy predicate. Okay, so this is called the self-blindness. Okay, so this is about the various kinds of the blindness, testing blindness, assignment blindness, equality blindness, and as well as the self blindness. And this is nothing but the predicate coverage. Okay, so what is the compound predicate? What is the predicate coverage? How many types of the testing blindness? And what is the assignment blindness? While assigning the value, okay, you have assigned the same value that will work for both buggy and normal situations. And equality blindness, you have selected a value, that particular value you have given, there it is showing for the correct value for the buggy and as well as non-buggy situations also. Assignment of a variable can makes works well for both the conditions, as the correct version and as well as the buggy version. So these are the various, so care must be taken while working with the assignment and equality of the statements. That's what it is saying. So this is all about the predicate coverage. In the coming video, we talk about the other things. Thank you for watching.